Hello everyone and a big welcome to the online certificate course in soft skill organized by IQSE Sri Anand College Pathardi. I'm Dr. Jayashree Khedkar and today I'll be dealing with one of the topics in soft skill, that is goal setting. Hope you will like it. So before we begin, let us first see what is goal. In simple terms, goal is an aim or your objective towards which you try to work hard. You set a target and then you try to reach that target or you try to achieve that target. I will give an example. Maybe as a student, your goal is to achieve good score in chemistry for the semester exam. So that's your goal. In order to get good score in coming semester exam, what you will do? You will attend the classes. You will make notes, you will take assignments, you will solve the problem, you will meet your teacher, you will discuss with your teacher, you will discuss among your friends and you will practice it, and then and only then you are going to get good score in the semester exam. So you set a target achieving good marks and you made a plan and you worked towards that plan. So this is an example of good goal. Suppose if you just think that I want to get good score in chemistry and you don't come to class, you don't attend the classes, you don't take notes, you don't take complete assignments, then you don't even talk with your teacher, you don't discuss chemistry among your classmates, you are not going to get good score, right? So just dreaming something is not important. That's just a dream. There is a clear-cut difference between a dream and a goal. So, a goal without a plan is a dream. Are you getting that? So, don't just dream. You have to make a plan and achieve your target. So, I hope you understood what is goal. Let us see the types of goal. Yes, there are types of goals. Short-term goals and long-term goals. So, short-term goals, as name suggests, these goals can be achieved in the near future. That time period can be a week, few weeks or a month. For example, you want to lose 2 kgs in coming 2 weeks. So that is a short term goal. That you are going to achieve your target within 2 weeks. You have set the timeline. The next type is long term goals. Long term goals may take longer time to achieve. That time can be a year or more than 1 year. For example, suppose now if you are in 12th standard and your goal is to become a graduate. So, you know that to become a graduate, you have to enter the first year, second year and third year. Then and after passing third year, you will get the graduate degree, right? So, this is a kind of long-term goal. It's going to take 3 years unless you fail. It's going to take 3 years to get a graduate degree. So, in order to complete these long-term goals, in between you can set some short-term goals. So, by adding all the short-term goals, ultimately you will reach to your long-term goal. So, these are the... After understanding of goal and types of goals, the question comes to your mind, what's the purpose of setting goal or goal setting? Because why we need to set the goal? Because without goal, you will be very much unfocused. You will be just thinking, "Arre, life mein kya karna hai? Mujhe to pata hi nahi, mujhe kya karna hai?" I always ask many students, my third year students, that what do you want to become in your life? They are clueless. They have no goal. Many of them. So you will be unfocused. You will feel unmotivated without having any goal. So always you must have a goal and you should set some goals for yourself. That goal can be in any field of life. That can be a relationship goal. That can be a career or academic goal. That can be a financial goal. That can be a personality development goal. That can be a family oriented goal. Goal can be of anything, right? So, goal give you the direction and keep you focused where you want to end up in your life. So, that's the ultimate purpose of goal setting. So, it's very important to set the goal. Now, once you decided to set the goal, Your goal should be SMART. It's the mnemonic SMART, where S stands for specific, M stands for measurable, A is attainable or achievable, R is relevant, and T is time bound. So, your goal should be specific. What does that mean? Your goal should be specific. That means your expected outcomes of that goal should be as simple as possible, as clear as possible. I can give you an example. For example, you want to lose 5 kgs within a month, right? So, for that, it's very specific that you have decided the timeline. You have decided how many kgs you want to lose, right? So, if you don't have the simple and clear target, then it's very difficult to reach that goal. You will be very much distracted, unfocused, and you will feel unmotivated also. I will give another example. Suppose your goal is to, you say, I want to become a better student. It's a very vague goal. What do you mean by getting or going to be a better student? It doesn't have any specificity. If you say that I'm going to focus on chemistry paper 1 course to improve my overall grade points. So that's a specific goal, right? Don't make vague goals. Ha, mujhe duniya badalni hai. That's a very stupid and vague goal, right? So, second thing is your goal should be measurable. Measurable, that's the name, suggests that you have to have some evidence to present that whether you met your goal or not. For example, I'm going to study Monday chemistry test. That's the very vague goal. It's not measurable. Instead of that, you can set a goal like, I'm going to study every day and then meet my teacher on Friday to prepare for Monday's class test. So, that's a measurable goal. The third one is A, that is attainable or achievable. Your goal outcomes should be achievable. That should be realistic. They should not cause you any tension or the stress. For example, you make a goal to lose 20 kgs within 2 weeks. Is that possible? It's not achievable. So, don't make goals which are unrealistic. Know your potential, know your capabilities, and then only make a goal. You can make a goal like, I'm going to lose 1 kg every week by choosing healthy diet. So, that is something achievable. The next one is relevant. Your goal should be relevant to your hobbies and your interests. So, it is very important to examine your goal. It's a realistic one. Like, for example, you like going to gym, then your goal can be, I want to become a good gym trainer. That is a relevant goal because you personally like going to gym and you can become a good trainer also. But you don't like maths or economics and you make a goal to become an accountant. That's very irrelevant, right? Are you getting that what I'm saying? So, it should be relevant. And the last one is time bound. Your goal should be achieved within realistic time frame. That means you have to define a deadline so that it will be always on your mind. It will create a healthy tension and a sense of urgency. For example, I will give you an example. I want to submit a short story in context next month. That's a very vague. It's not time bound. Next month is which next month? You have not defined which month, from when you are going to start. Nothing is defined. So, it's a bad example of goal. Instead of that, what you can say that I'm going to draft an outline for my first short story this Monday. So, that is you are giving Monday. That means you are giving a date on which day you are going to draft your first story. So, while setting a goal, you have to keep in mind these SMART things. I hope you understand. I will give you an example. Since you are students, I will give the academic, how you can set the academic SMART goal. For example, your overall goal is I want to be a better student. So, as I said earlier, it's not a good goal. What do you mean by becoming a better student? So, instead of that, you should goal or your SMART goal should look like I will target the course having lowest grade to raise my overall GPA. That means I want to increase my percentage by focusing on the course in which I got the low marks, right? So specific, I want to improve my overall GPA so I can apply for scholarship in next semester. That's a clear goal, specific and clear. It's very much clear in your mind why you want to improve your grade, right? The second is measurable. So measurable means what? How you are going to improve, how you will measure that you improved your grade. Suppose you got a C grade earlier, so this time you want to earn B grade or better in your chemistry midterm exam. So if you get the B grade, that is something measurable. You are measuring your success, or that gives you the idea whether you achieved your goal or not, right? So your goal should be achievable. Achievable means you have to, you got C or D grade earlier and you are aiming for O or something. It's very difficult. From C, you will go step by step, right? From C, you will try to or you will aim to reach B, and from B, then you will go to higher step. So your goal should be achievable and not the way. You got the D grade and you are aiming for O grade. That's not, that may be possible if you work hard, but it's always better to go step by step. Then relevant. Relevant, like suppose you are aiming to get good score and your good score or good GPA will help you to reduce your student loan for the next semester. Suppose you are taking some loan and pursuing your studies, then if you get a good score, then that loan can be reduced. Maybe that's one of the goal. So your GPA or your percentage are going to reduce your loan. So there is a relevancy between this goal, right? Time bound. So suppose you have the goal to get the good score in the midterm exam. So you have 6 weeks to reach to that midterm exam. So you have enough time to meet your teacher. You have enough time to discuss the important steps to be followed to improve your subject knowledge, right? So this is how one can set a academic SMART goal. This is just one example. You may plan another. You can take it as an exercise. Decide any goal in your life. I have given the example in academic field. You can choose personal, personality development, your financial, your family, and divide that into the SMART goal. Right? Now, we learned that why we want to set the goal. Now, I will give you steps for goal setting. Yeah, you may find different steps and different resources, but overall, the first step to goal setting is identify your goal. You must know what is your goal. Once you identify your goal in that particular area of your life, then you have to set the objectives. Objectives is I want to achieve this. I need something. Whatever you want to achieve for. So you set the objective. Objectives are the practical steps needed to help you to achieve that goal. So once you set the objective, then you have to list the obstacles that agar aap kuch decide kar rahe ho, you are deciding something ani madhye kay tari adthala yetoy ki mala he karayche parantu ya karanamule mi he karu shakat nahi, tar tumhala te sagle olkhayche. For example, tumhala shikhnyachi khup ichcha ahe pan tumhi garib ahat, earn and learn sarkya scheme madhun tumhi shikshan ghetay pan त्या कामाची वेळ आणि तुमच्या कॉलेजची वेळ ओव्हरलॅप होती, तर तो एक एक प्रकारचा तो अडथळा आहे तुमच्या एम मध्ये किंवा गोल मध्ये. तर तुम्ही तो दूर कसा, असे अडथळे तुम्ही ओळखायचे आणि तो दूर कसा करायचा, तर त्याच्यावरती तुम्ही काहीतरी उपाय शोधायचा. एक तर तुम्ही मग कॉलेजचा वेळ बदला किंवा नाईट स्कूल जॉईन करू शकता, या अशा प्रकारे तुम्ही तुमचं ऑब्स्टॅकल ओळखून यू हॅव टू ओव्हरकम दॅट, राईट? देन द नेक्स्ट वन इज आयडेंटिफाय पीपल. या सगळ्या गोष्टींमधनं जाताना, गोल सेटिंग करताना, विच पीपल आर गोइंग टू हेल्प यू, कुठले लोक महत्वाचे आहेत आणि कोण तुम्हाला यात मदत करणार आहे हे तितकंच हे ओळखणं आणि त्याची यादी बनवणं हे तितकंच महत्वाचं आहे. द नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज लिस्ट स्किल्स. आता त्या एम पर्यंत गोल पर्यंत जाण्यासाठी तुम्हाला काय काय स्किल्स लागतात आणि वेदर यू हॅव ऑर यू पजेस दो स्किल्स ऑर नॉट, सो यू हॅव टू मेक अ लिस्ट ऑफ दॅट. देन आफ्टर ऑर्गनायझिंग ऑल दिस, फॉलोइंग ऑल दिस स्टेप्स, द नेक्स्ट वन इज डेव्हलप अ प्लॅन. यू हॅव टू मेक अ प्रॉपर प्लॅन. विदाउट प्लॅनिंग नथिंग इज गोइंग टू वर्क. सो यू हॅव टू डेव्हलप अ प्लॅन अँड ऑल्सो यू हॅव टू लिस्ट द बेनिफिट्स. बेनिफिट्स म्हणजे काय की हे मी पूर्ण केलं तर मला काय मिळणार आहे. सपोज माझ्या आयुष्याचं माझं एम होतं की मला पीएचडी मिळवायची, त्यानंतर पीएचडी मिळवल्यानंतर मला जॉब मिळवायचा, जॉब मिळाला की मला खूप छान सॅलरी मिळेल, माझं सॅटिस्फॅक्शनही असेल, मला टीचिंग आवडतं. तर मला जर मी पीएचडी पूर्ण केली, मी जर टीचर झाले तर मला काय काय फायदे होणार आहे ह्याची मी यादी आधीच केलेली होती आणि त्या फायद्यांकडे पाहून मी सतत माझं एम माझ्या डोळ्यासमोर राहिलं आणि मी ते पूर्ण करण्याचा प्रयत्न केला. सो बेनिफिट्स का आपण लिस्ट आउट करायचे, एक स्वार्थी भावना म्हणून नाही, बेनिफिट्स का लिस्ट आउट करायचे की तुम्हाला एक त्याच्यातनं मोटिवेशन मिळतं. तुम्ही ते नेहमी मोटिवेट होत राहता, अरे मी हे केलं तर मला हे मिळणार आहे. सो फॉर दॅट रिझन ऑलवेज लिस्ट आउट द बेनिफिट्स. सो दीज आर फ्यू स्टेप्स दॅट यू विल हॅव टू फॉलो फॉर द गोल सेटिंग. देन I will also give some tips for the goal setting. Ki goal set kartana, make a realistic goal. Always devise a plan. Devise a plan, make a plan and follow that plan strictly. Committed asla paije aapla goal kade. त्यानंतर प्रायोरिटीज दिल्या पाहिजेत. काहीतरी अभ्यासाचं गोल केलाय, मला ह्या ग्रॅज्युएशन मिळवायचंय किंवा मला केमिस्ट्रीमध्ये खूप छान मार्क्स मिळवायचेत, तर मग तुम्ही प्रायोरिटी ही अभ्यासाला द्यायला हवी केमिस्ट्री सब्जेक्टच्या, दुसऱ्या विषयांमध्ये नाही. प्रायोरिटी वरती तुमचा नेहमी केमिस्ट्रीचा अभ्यास असला पाहिजे. सो यू हॅव टू मेक द प्रायोरिटीज आणि अशी एक लिस्ट बनवावं लागेल प्रायोरिटीजची की आधी जो माझा गोल आहे त्याला मी पहिली प्रायोरिटी देणार आणि बाकीच्या ज्या माझ्या हॉबीज असतील किंवा माझा स्पेअर टाइम असेल तो मी कसा घालवणार ह्याच्यासाठी तुम्हाला दुसरी लिस्ट बनवावी लागेल. सो यू हॅव टू सेट द डेडलाईन्स. सेमिस्टर एक्झाम आता 6 आठवड्यांनी येणार आहे तर तुम्हाला डेडलाईन सेट करावी लागणार आहे. एक वर्षानंतर डेडलाईन सेट करून उपयोग नाहीये, राईट? सो यू हॅव टू सेट द डेडलाईन्स आणि सेल्फ इव्हॅल्युएशन करत राहायचंय आपल्या गोल्सचं की आपल्याला आपण आपल्या गोलपर्यंत पोहोचतोय की नाही पोहोचतोय. आणि त्यानंतर एकदा सगळं आपले गोल अचीव केल्यानंतर स्वतःला एक छानस रिवॉर्ड द्यायचं, स्वतःलाच एक शाबासकी द्यायची किंवा स्वतःला एखादं काहीतरी गिफ्ट स्वतःच बाय करायचं. दॅट इज रिवॉर्ड युअर सेल्फ फॉर अन अकम्प्लिशमेंट बिकॉज यू अचीव दॅट गोल, यू वर्क हार्ड फॉर दॅट गोल, सो यू डिझर्व द रिवॉर्ड. एक छोटस चॉकलेट किंवा खूप जास्त असतील पैसे तर तुम्ही एखादं डीव्हीडी किंवा सीडी पण घेऊ शकता किंवा स्वतःला जे आवडतं असं एखादं पुस्तकही गिफ्ट करू शकता. सो बाय रिवॉर्डिंग यू ऑलवेज कीप युअर सेल्फ मोटिवेटिंग. सो दीज आर फ्यू टिप्स. आय होप यू लाइक दी ऑर यू अंडरस्टूड दी गोल सेटिंग. इफ यू हॅव एनी डाऊट यू कॅन लीव द कमेंट्स अँड थँक्यू फॉर लिसनिंग.